All right, Jeff Bruhl and I just completed the long drive from the North Shore of Lake Pontchartrain to here at Cypress Cove Marina in Venice at the mouth of the Mississippi River. The river is super low this year, below 3 feet, and that's got everything pulled out. We've got big plans for the next couple days. But you know what they say about plans? We'll see if they actually happen. All right, Jeff and I are starting the morning, literally 5 minutes from Cypress Cove. Just a classic Venice scene. Lots of elephant ears and roseau cane. Just a little nothing cut. Uh-oh.
Nope.
Oh, alligator, look at that. What's up, buddy? He doesn't even care. And there are lots of ways you can catch Venice bass, but none is more fun than flipping and pitching. And I'm doing that with I think this is called cobalt. It's a matrix craw, kind of a blue flake with, I don't know, maybe green pumpkin. I just got a lot of confidence in this color. So that's what I'm starting with. Jeff, you're throwing what?
I got a punch skirt with a pit ball.
Punch skirt with a pit ball. What color, you know?
It's, I think, an Okeechobee.
Let's see.
It's kind of a green with a blue.
Okay.
And the thick stuff when the tide's high, you got to get it way back in there.
Yeah, the tide is super high right now. In fact, Jeff and I are theorizing that we're at the actual peak of high tide, which is, you know, not ideal for Venice. You really want to fish a falling tide, but, you know, the good news with that is we'll have a falling tide the rest of the day.
See stuff like that.
You got to fish it, huh? Instead of going blowing by like I'm doing.
Yeah.
I'm fishing this matrix craw beneath a 3/8 ounce tungsten bullet weight that I have pegged. Pegging is essential down here. And Jeff and I have the good fortune of staying at a buddy's camp tonight, so we've got all day. Come on, Bass, you gotta be somewhere. You have to be somewhere. What the hell is that? Boy, you wanna come running in here, look at that.
Yeah, that's it.
Like a wing dam or something. That'll eat your lower unit. Mm. Oh, I don't know, man.
Grab
it. I don't know. I'm not saying it was a fish. Wouldn't bet my life. My front end, are you good enough?
Yep.
There he is. That's not a bad bass, Jeff.
Nice bass.
All right. In the boat, he'll eat. That fish is way up in that thick stuff. All right, I'm gonna get you. Settle down. Got some other priorities at the moment. You wrecked my craw.
Thump it or get it?
You know, no, he didn't thump it. I went to pick it up and felt him. All right, we caught only one bass in that little cut, but on Jeff's last trip out here, they caught a bunch of freshwater cats right here by the Cypress Cove cleaning dock. So we brought some bait shrimp, and we're gonna see if we can catch some. You just dropping down?
Just dropping straight down. I found out we don't hang up as much when you do that.
All right. See if he comes up.
No blue cat.
There we go.
There we go.
Nice. That's what we came for.
That's a whole fry there.
Man, you're right.
Get him down, fry him whole.
There's some dinner. Now, is he also a Lone Ranger?
I don't think so. All right, the big question is, do you prefer the head or the tail?
I prefer the tail. How about you?
I like the head.
All right, we'll make a good team. Well, I think he is.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's a better one, Jeff. There we go.
I'm back here to back it,
buddy. Yeah, I think I will.
To the bank, you're right.
Ooh, look at that. Something was destroying bait right there. Oh. Are you setting the hook or no?
Yeah. When you feel him, kind of let him take it just a second. There's some small ones here now.
But that's a keeper.
That's a whole fry there.
It's a keeper. I'll take him. Got him? There we go.
Hardy head or catfish head? Catfish head.
That's a good All right, so this is pure meat haul fishing, but that doesn't mean it's not a blast. A lot of fun, very productive. Of course, these fish are delicious to eat. All we're doing is dropping down to the bottom, reeling up a couple of feet, and just waiting. There he is. There he is. That's a little guppy. Oh, there he is. There he is. It's better than the last one. Just making me real opposite handed. There we go. Jeff, look what came out of this one's mouth.
A hook?
Yep. Somebody already caught him. There you got him. Perfect. Perfect. Jeff said, you come here right at dark, pretty well automatic, but we're nowhere near dark. It's like maybe, I don't know, 9 o'clock or so. And it's pretty close to automatic. There he is. Feel like I'm offshore, dropping straight down, reeling with my right hand. But I'll be happy I did this Friday night when I'm eating them. So Jeff, you figure these catfish are here eating the discards from that cleaning table, right?
Right, but they're all over. Really.
But they're all over, right? That's what I was gonna ask you. There's a whole lot of places you go and do this.
Yeah, you wanna look for points, deep holes, current coming around a point.
Okay.
You usually just hit 1 ounce to 1.5 ounce weight. But sometimes the key is to throw
fish
it.
Fish on. Double! So nice. This is awesome. All right, go ahead. Sometimes the key is what?
The key is not throwing out in the middle. The key is throwing close to the bank, because what happens is that tide comes out and makes an eddy up against the bank, and they sit in
that's the where they're sitting.
So,
okay.
Like, see, we're not that far off the bank.
Right.
In the same way, if you went to a point, sometimes you want to throw right against the bank, because in Venice, you get big drop-offs.
Right.
These banks. And sometimes they will be on a shelf or something out in the middle when you throw out there, but a lot of times you just drop it right down the side of the bank and you catch it.
Okay. Yeah, and all we're doing is dropping straight down. How deep's the water right here?
Let's see. It is 10 and a half, 12 feet.
10 and a half to 12 feet. So not all that shallow, pretty deep.
Well, the main reason we're throwing down is because all this is lined with rocks, and you're going to hang up on the rocks every time you throw it out. So just drop it straight down.
So why are we dropping straight down?
See how the rocks? You got a lot of fallen rocks. So if you throw out in the current with the rocks, you just hang up every can.
Okay.
So just drop it straight. When you get places like this, just drop it straight down.
No reason to cast.
Yep.
Now these catfish, of course, do have spines right here on each fin, and then one on the dorsal fin. So you want to use a rag to hold them below those spines, those barbs, to pull your hook out. We picked up bait shrimp on the way down here. And that's what we're using. You see, it's really, really tiny. And Jeff caught one really nice one, but mostly these fish are just a pound or two, about what they're averaging. Those little cats, great to eat. Oh.
That line and
oh.
He was pulling the
looks like a decent one.
Yeah. What you noticed the other day that.
Oh, another double. What'd you notice the other day?
Like the catfish kind of come up. The hardheads did.
Yeah. Oh, looky there. Taught him a lesson. You need that rag?
Yeah.
Meat haul, baby. I'll take it. I'll take it.
You don't like catfish, do you?
I hate them. I'll eat them all so you don't have to. That's going to be a wake.
Yeah.
Get him, Jeff. Nice one, real nice one. Now he's gonna slow down. That's a nasty wake, heads up. Oh, uh-oh, bad timing. Bad timing. Everybody hold on. Yeah, he's on there. Not a bad one. So that is one thing you do have to deal with down here, these wakes. This is a high traffic area from a lot of big boats, a lot of shrimp boats, crew boats, offshore boats. I'll take that rag, thank you. These wakes are pretty nasty. There we go.
Well, obviously the bass fishing didn't work out in the morning, but it definitely did that afternoon. To see that video, check back here later this week on the Marshman Masson channel. In the meantime, be sure and subscribe. See you later in the week.